Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming. I'm just having the chair here just in case my legs get tired, but not that I need them. I'm going to talk about you about sustainable thinking, and it is indeed not what you might think that it is. The last pillar, and that's the pillar that we many times forget in the triangle, that is inspiration. Something that Baudina just gave us in the financial department, that Sabina just gave us in the environmental department, and I hope to give you that in the emotional department. And it all starts in the heart. Whatever you want to do, it all starts here. My name is Andrew Greg Mitchell Clemens Kirchner. My mother knew from the moment I was born, this boy is going to be trouble. And I made that promise come true. My friends call me Andy because I have a speech impediment. I can't say the R very well. So my friends started calling me Andy to make it easy on me after they teased me for many, many years. But some people also know me as the recycled pirate. And in my talk, you'll understand a little bit why. It's not just because of the recycling. I'm going to talk a little bit about sustainability first and explain that. I mean, we all know what sustainability means. We all learned this. It's very simple. Economy, environment, society. And together, it's sustainability. And as you can see, I did it on purpose. Sustainability is a little bit squashed in the middle. And let me show you why. This is how it looks in the classroom. It starts to get a little bit more difficult. You have to start thinking about the equitable parts, the viable parts, and the bearable parts. And especially the bearable parts are a whole different story. Because this is how sustainability looks in real life. Looks familiar? You have to get here on time. You have to pay your car. You have to eat. But you don't have time for that. You don't have the money for that. So how else are you going to be sustainable? Well, I got to figure that out all by myself, lying in a hospital bed, paralyzed, just being in contract negotiations to get a contract, but I didn't have a contract. I had no income. I had no future, and I still have no pension. I have no future unless I keep standing on my legs. If I fall down tomorrow, well, it starts with the letter F and it finishes with UCK. So sustainable thinking, well, you become what you consume. As I was lying in that hospital bed and all these thoughts coming through my head, how I'm going to do this with my future, and my family is coming to my bed and telling me how horrible my life looks for the future, and what if the SVB is not going to pay for my bills, and what I'm going to do now, and I'm lying there and I'm waiting for the nurses to come wipe my butt, and I realize I am definitely UCKed. I had to find a solution for myself, but there was no way because I was stuck in a hospital bed. So the first step was to find a stability for myself. And that stability first came with fighting all the mental issues, turning them off and focusing on the future. The next step would be getting out of that bed, learning how to walk again, and after that, we'll see further. Well, after learning to walk again, of course, came learning to drive again, learning to create my own business, that's why I'm here, and eventually even love again. But that brought me on a whole different path, because before I could do that, I first have to pay for myself. Here in Curaçao, we don't have a social system that will really catch you when you fall. I got a social welfare after begging for it for almost a year, and it was a whopping 180 guilders or 160 guilders, I don't even remember, every 2 weeks. And I had to travel for over a year to get that, for over an hour to get that money, to travel back an hour to finally get back to my bed so I could rest. My future was starting to look very, very grim because finally I learned to walk. Finally, I was trying to get sustainable back, but this was not going to be an option for the future. I did not do all the things that I did as a bartender, as a DJ, as a salsa teacher, as a nature guide, as a dive instructor, to be depending on your money for the rest of my life. So I went to look for your waste, what you throw away. I started to find ways to make my money with it. I was afraid that a social service welfare would find me and would come and take my money away. But it was the first attempt to be sustainable again. If I ever wanted to mean something back in my life for myself and for other people, I first had to find a value in my life again. And I started with things that other people threw away. Before I knew it, the cans that I would find in my yard, the stones that I would find in my yard, the kalbas, coconuts, they started to travel around the world. People found me through social media. Social media has made the world this small. And before I knew it, one of my art pieces was standing in Australia, was standing in New York, was standing in Holland. And I got more and more requests. As a joke, I thought I'm going to participate in the GCI Ayoba Aspiring Creative Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. Don't shoot me, I didn't come up with that name. I had no clue what an entrepreneur was. I didn't even care. I just wanted to make a living. I just wanted to survive. But I won it. And with the wins of it, instead of me finally opening my foundation, Second Life Curaçao, that I dreamt of, I decided to do something completely different. I didn't want to be the next one to hold up his hand and ask you for money for a foundation. There are too many people that are doing that. And for example, C30 Conservation, Fundación Altan Paz, need that way more than I do, because I have a big mouth, I can do it for myself. So when I went to the notary, that was part of the prize that I won, I talked to the notary and I said, I want to make sure that I do this on myself, so I want to start my own business. And I wanted to call it Buccaneer Enterprises BV. On his advice, it became Buccaneer His Enterprise BV, because he understood immediately where this prize stood for. So now, right now, I'm the managing director of Buccaneers Enterprises BV. That doesn't mean squat, by the way, because I still have to pick up all these cans, I still have to wash them, I still have to make them, I still have to sell them, I still have to market them, and I still have to come and speak here in front of you with my knee hurting, my back hurting, or whatever is hurting that day. Not that I'm complaining, because I'm loving my life the way it is. Why? Because when we raise our value, we increase our worth. By doing what I'm doing, my neighbor knocked on my door and asked me, hey, Andy, what you're doing is amazing. Can you help me? I want to become a pilot, but I don't know how, and my English is not that good. Well, I'll tutor you. Well, if you're going to tutor me, I will pay you. And I thought, hey, see, now money is coming in. And he started paying me. And someone else asked me, hey, Andy, how are you dealing with all those physical pains? I said, I breathe. You breathe? How do you breathe? I meditate. What is meditation? Well, let me explain. And they started paying me for that. And little by little, I started selling my products and started selling myself. And that's how the Recycled Pirate came to life. With the Recycled Pirate, I had the chance to become a spokesperson for people with a physical disability. And I became a spokesperson for the Paralympics. I became a board member for Fundación Desarrollo Deportivo Curaçao. And for the first time in my life, for 4 years long, I had, I forgot the English name, a bestuursfunctie. I had to manage the managing director of a local foundation. And that was a whole new experience for me. And not just a whole new experience for me, but also for the experience that I could give others and what they could do with themselves. I knew that with everything I did, I was going to be an example for others, if I wanted to or not. You cannot hide. So during this period of time, I started to see the examples of sustainable thinking. Because with everyone that I touched and everyone that touched me, I noticed we keep falling in the same things. And many things are with women, for example, they're many times too emotional. With men, many times they don't express their emotions too much or enough. So I started coaching them, first the men, and then later the women, and now even some couples. Examples of sustainable thinking. History, learning from your past. Many times we stay stuck in the pain. We can't do something anymore because it hurt us once. Well, you keep staying in that pain, it's gonna hurt you again. You let that pain go, you can live in the present. And once you live in that present, you can make connections with the people surrounding you. And once you start making connections with the people surrounding you, so you took a good look at Baudinus' presentation, that's how they got Scandicash to the market because they looked at the future but lived in the present. So, to live sustainability, what is sustainability to me? You have to dare to question yourself. I stand here and I'm talking to you and it might seem like I know everything. I coach people, so, hey, this dude must know everything. Well, I know squat. I know what I know, and I know what I'm experiencing right now, and I know I will have some more experience later on in the break and once I get home and can finally be alone with my partner. But sustainability to me, what it means that whatever I'm doing right now, I have to make sure that I don't give too much of me now, so I can still give you something in the break, and so I can still give something to my partner later. And why is sustainability important to me? Well, because if I give everything now and I can't talk to you in the break and I can't help you later, then I wasted my energy on just one thing. And there are at least three things that we can do tonight. And I want to make sure that I save my energy for the next thing that can come. I want to make sure that if there is an emergency, I still have energy left. And what we do many times, we go to work, we give our all, and then we're too tired to talk to the kids. We're too tired to talk to our spouse. We're too tired to talk to our moms. Instead of saving that little bit of energy, so you can give them some importance too, because they are important to you in your life. Am I living as sustainable as I can? Well, that's a question that I can give you a very, very simple two-letter word answer on. Nope. Not possible, not even if I wanted to. I have to work to make a living, and that means that I have to push through my physical pains, through my mental pains, through all my spiritual dilemmas, just like any one of you. The difference is with me is that I, lying in my hospital bed, found a way to find a balance. I had the chance to observe people for a month long, how they were stressing at my bed, while I found and figured a way to get out of my bed. And they were figuring a way to keep me in that bed. And that's where the difference comes between me and most people that I coach. My way of sustainable living is knowing that I'm giving everything that I can, but in a balanced way. So I'll be sure to give you something tomorrow also. A good example of sustainable thinking, as I said already with Baudino, we got a good look at how the economy works. We got a great way with Sabine on how the environmental part works. And I'm coming with the little boring part for most people, and that's the emotional side. But it's very important because this emotional side gives me the chance to teach at schools, gives me the chance to talk in boardrooms, and gave me the chance to inspire some people to make changes. And that's why inspiration is the fourth pillar of sustainability. Because without inspiration, I could not produce local, I could not buy local, to educate local, and to understand local. And because I inspire, I'm selling not just Curaçao, but also my products everywhere. And for the future, that's what I'm gonna give Curaçao even more. Thank you for your time.